A mother, her son, and a 50-year search. The heartbreaking story of a mother and the son she had to give away. One of the themes that I think is appropriate for the lost child of Philomena Lee is hope, because even though many obstacles were thrown in their way, they never lost hope on finding each other. Another theme for the lost child of Philomena Lee is tragedy, because in the end they don't end up meeting. Instead, Philomena learns that her son died before Anthony's birth. Philomena gets pregnant and is sent to the convent by her family to have her baby. She ends up having a son named Anthony. Around the time of Anthony's third birthday, Philomena is forced to sign her rights away by the nuns. A few months later, an American family comes to Ireland looking to adopt a little girl, but they develop a bond with Anthony as well, which causes them to adopt both Mary and Anthony. They leave for America, and after being in America for a few months, Marge, Anthony's adoptive mother, decides that Anthony's name should be changed to Mike. Changing his name causes him to lose the last piece of Philomena he has left. A few years later, of being in America, Mike develops a close bond with Loris, who is his uncle. After Loris' death, Mike starts to misbehave and talk back to his parents, which is really surprising since he was the obedient child while Mary was the disobedient child. Later on, when it is time for Mike to go to law school, he and his father disagree on which school to go to. In the end, Mike ends up going to the law school he wants to. During his time at law school, Mike goes to church and finally confesses that he is gay. After the confession, he goes to a lot of gay bars because he feels a sense of belonging at the gay bars. Also, his confession makes him realize that he wants to go back to Ireland to look for his mother. When he goes to the convent, the nuns refuse to tell him anything. Anthony even says to the nuns that, "We've always been told our mothers abandoned us at birth, but I have strong memories of my own mother being here with me at some stage." But still, the nuns don't tell him anything. They return back to America even though Anthony feels that his mother is also searching for him. As time passed by, his mother Marge was admitted to the hospital and died, which caused him great grief. After moving on from his mother's death, not only does he graduate law school, but he also meets his lifetime partner Pete. Years later, with him and Pete being in a strong relationship, they find out Mike has AIDS. After learning about his diagnosis, he and alongside Pete decide to go to Ireland one last time to try to find Philomena. When they get to the convent, the nuns still refuse to give Mike any information about his birth mother, even after he says that he's going to die soon. He persuades them with money to let his grave rest at the convent because he is hopeful that his mother will see his grave when she is at the convent looking for him. Beyond the grave. What Mike didn't know was that his birth mother is also looking for him since he has been taken. She also goes back to the convent to see if they have any information on Mike. But just like the nuns do for Mike, they refuse to give Philomena any information. The second time she visited this convent, she sees Mike's tombstone. With the information on the tombstone, she's able to find more information about his life in America. Also, she manages to meet his friends and family, including Pete. Philomena now visits her son's grave constantly. If that's not enough, multi-time award winner Dame Judi Dench loved the book, and she says it's the most extraordinary story. It's a remarkable journey. Also, in a recent group study, everyone adored the book and said they would buy it immediately after it is published, which means if our publishing house publishes The Lost Child of Philomena, our profits will increase. The messages in The Lost Child of Philomena Lee are never to lose hope and don't hold grudges.